गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल, वेलकम टू द सेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट यूनिट नंबर 1। द टॉपिक नेम इज हीट ट्रांसफर एंड एनर्जीज। बिफोर गोइंग ऑन, आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस दैट वेरी बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन एयर स्टैंडर्ड साइकिल्स एंड एक्चुअल साइकिल्स। दैट एयर स्टैंडर्ड साइकिल्स इज कॉल्ड एज आइडियल साइकिल्स। So without considering losses, that air standard cycles, which is corrected with characteristics of air fuel mixer, then that cycle is converted to fuel air cycles. Again, that fuel air cycles is corrected for losses is called actual cycles. You know that actual cycle efficiency probably 40 to 50% and 55% is maximum efficiency. Okay, then losses in actual cycles. First loss is time loss and heat loss, blow down loss, blow by loss, rubbing loss, pumping loss. Okay, time loss, it is due to time required for mixing of air fuel mixer and complete combustion. Once again, I will repeat, it is due to the time required for mixing of air fuel mixer and complete combustion. This is time loss. That means that heat addition is not instantaneous and spread over a period. That means that is 30 to 40 degrees crank shaft revolution. That maximum pressure is not TDC, it is after TDC. The time loss is depends upon flame velocity, which in turn again depends on the type of fuel and type of combustion chamber and shape of combustion chamber and air fuel ratio. Okay, this time loss is completely depending on that air fuel ratio and what type of fuel you are used and shape of the combustion chamber. Okay, that crank revolution is 30 to 40 degrees. That maximum pressure is peak, that maximum pressure or peak pressure in after TDC, not exit TDC. Okay, then try to recollect on the combustion, maybe SI engines and CI engines. Combustion is nothing but the form of energy converted into one form to another form. Basically, what is done? Fuel is a family of hydrocarbons. That hydrocarbon means this is the one chemical form. Okay, this is one chemical form. That chemical energy converted into another form of energy. That another form of energy is called heat energy. This is known as done by a process which is called combustion. That chemical energy fuel, that hydrocarbon bond, that hydrocarbon bond converted into that chemical energy fuel into the other form of energy. That other form of energy is called heat energy. Okay, then next, heat transfer and energy. For example, I would like to discuss with you one equation, that is CX, that CX is hydrocarbon plus O2, that hydrocarbon combined with O2 is gives rise to that CO2 plus H2O plus Q, that Q is called heat. Okay, once again, CX, that CX is called hydrocarbon combined with oxygen, that O2 is gives rise to that equation. How look like to convert that CO2 plus H2O plus Q, that Q is the form of heat. This equation is called exothermic equation. I hope you know about that. What is exothermic equation? That if you take any system, that if you take any system, that system is thermodynamic system. Heat released to surrounding. Okay, one form of energy is converted to another form of energy. That form is heat. That heat is transferred to system to surrounding. Okay, that type of equation is called exothermic equation, especially in heat. Lot of examples is there, light source and different examples. Because of the temperature create heat, piston is thrust on the force. That thrust for based on that thrust force, engine is run. Okay. Now the question is, the amount of heat generated because of the reaction, is it possible that the heat which is developed can be transferred available work? That means, once again, I will show that exothermic reaction, that CX plus O2 is equalized to CO2 plus H2O plus Q. That means the heat energy is totally converted to useful work. This is the question. In actual engines, only 50 to 55% efficiency. But what about remaining heat? Is loss in different ways or different forms. Then heat loss. What is heat loss? This is due to the transfer of heat through water jackets and cooling fins. Also, some heat being transferred during compression and expansion strokes. Heat loss means this is due to the transfer of heat through water jackets and cooling fins. Also, some heat being transferred during compression and expansion strokes. Due to heat loss, maximum temperature in cylinder decreases. This is very basic. Due to heat loss, that inside temperature is reduced. What happened in inside temperature? What happened in reducing inside temperature? You know, if any system, it should maintain maximum pressure, then only you get good performance and good efficiency. But here, due to heat loss, maximum temperature in cylinder is decreases and specific heat is also decreases, the efficiency is also decrease. Next, blowdown loss. It is due to early opening of exhaust valves. This results in drop in pressure and a loss of work output. It is due to early opening of exhaust valves. This results in drop in pressure and loss of work output during expansion stroke. You know that process. What happened initially, for example, considering in as SI engine, that air fuel mixer, that homogeneous mixer entering into the in cylinder, then piston travel from top to bottom, that is TDC to BDC, then next stroke is compression stroke, again piston travel from BDC to TDC, of end of the TDC, help of spark plug, then combustion takes place in cylinder, that end of that exhaust valve, early opening of exhaust valve means after compression stroke, immediately that exhaust valve is opened, what happened, that high pressure and high temperature, that high amount of heat is loss. That heat is released to exhaust through exhaust valves to atmosphere or outside the cylinder. So it is very important factor that valve opening and spark ignition. Then next loss is blow by loss. It is due to the leakage of gases through different ways. For example, in your engine, lot of equipments and lot of moving parts is there. Then gaps between the piston and piston rings and cylinder walls. Okay, gaps between piston rings and cylinder walls, that heat is leaked in different ways. This type of loss is called blow by loss. Okay, then finally rubbing friction loss. It is due to friction between the piston and chamber walls and other any moving parts. Okay, lot of parts is there in our engine. For example, that energy is spent in operating various auxiliary equipments such as cooling fans and water pumps and water jackets and different equipments is there. Then pumping loss, it is due to low inlet pressure and high exhaust pressure. Okay, that pumping loss means low intake pressure and high exhaust pressure. Okay, these are the different losses in IC engines. Okay, once again, that losses are time loss, heat loss, blow down loss, blow by loss, rubbing loss and pumping loss. Okay, then one important parameter is that spark ignition and spark advance. As per that laboratory data, that for example you considering that fuel air cycles, that ignition is in 0 degrees, that maximum pressure is 44 bars and mean effective pressure is 10.20, that efficiency around 32 and 33% only. Then actual cycles, 0 degrees, that maximum pressure is 23 bar and 7.50 is mean effective pressure, efficiency around 24%. Then 17 degrees, 34 bars is maximum pressure and mean effective pressure is 8.35 and efficiency is 26.3% only. Then 35 degrees, that crank revolution is 35 degrees, maximum pressure is 41 bar and mean effective pressure is 7.60 and efficiency around 23.9. Observed this above data, that 0 degrees is advanced spark, 35 degrees is too late. What you observed in this data, early valve opening and too late valve opening is not suitable for this engine, that is the crank revolution, that means 70 degrees before TDC, the spark is generated, that maximum pressure is 34 and mean effective pressure is 8.35 bars and efficiency is 26.3%. This is the safe and good efficiency. Okay, as per this laboratory calculations. Okay, then one more important point I would like to discuss with you in this session. In our first unit, have two topics. One is difference between that air standard cycles and air fuel cycles and actual cycles. We are already discussed in thermodynamics and as well as in our past lectures also, in classroom lectures, that air standard cycle is completely ideal cycle, have a high performance and high efficiency because of you are not considering any type of loss. That example is auto cycle and diesel cycle and dual cycle. Try to derive that auto, diesel and dual cycles. You know that auto cycle have a four process, one two constant volumes and two isentropics, and diesel cycle have a one constant pressure and one constant volume and two isentropics, and dual cycle is two constant volumes and one isobaric and two isentropic process. Based on this process, try to derive that equations and try to solve very basic problems. Okay. Thank you.